Hey guys, it's Shonda Hunt, and I want to go over some pretty cool nodes that handle some common prep and compositing tasks in Nuke. In the draw category of nodes, there are some handy nodes such as the Dustbust node, as well as the MarkerRemoval node. So we all know that one common task is to remove the tracking markers from the shot. And then there's also a task known as Dustbusting, which removes dust and scratches from the images by painting over them with pixels from another frame or another part of the same frame. This tool can also be used for common comp tasks such as painting out snow. We'll go over this tool later. For now, let's look at this marker removal node. The marker removal node does need a roto shape or a mat. So we'll go ahead and create our roto node, which is also under the draw category. So we could have brought it in here as well. So now we have our roto node. And let's go ahead and just draw some shapes over these tracking markers. Let's see what happens. So we can see this is already doing a pretty good job of just removing the markers. So what you could do is you could go ahead, track your shot, draw your shapes, add your tracker to the shot, and then you'll have your markers removed. Now, if you can see, there is some still faint hints of the tracking markers. So let's look at the marker removal settings to see how we can dial this in a little bit further. If we adjust the bilinear stretch, the bilinear search, we see that now we're getting rid of that. So very cool note to simply get rid of those tracking markers very fast and easy by just drawing your shape. I do want to note my plate came in with an alpha, so I had to go ahead and remove that alpha so that my marker removal is only looking for the mats or the alpha of the roto that I created. So pay attention to that. If your plate has an alpha already, you will want to go ahead and remove that alpha so that you can use this tool. Now let's take a look at the Dustbust tool. So when we're having footage, oftentimes there are some white highlights or some lines or some stretching that appear. I didn't have any footage with actual dust busting problems, but I did, or dirt or scratches in the plate. But I did have this shot that is just snow falling, and it reminded me of a time when I had to paint out hundreds of frames of snow. And I was like, let's see how well this tool works on those types of tasks. So once you attach your Dustbust node to the plate, you will need to hold down the control button and click where you want to Dustbust. And once you have this little box appear, you can go ahead and hold down the control even further to expand the shape of this. Now this node is just drawing using pixels from another frame. So what you need to do is adjust the frame offset if it's still showing up. So let's take a look. It did move over, but since this snow is falling, I'm sure that the snow is just falling a little bit more in the frame that is referencing, which is currently offset to 1. So all we have to do, I'll go ahead and turn this box off so we can see what's happening. And if you don't know, if you want to turn off the overlay, you just press the Q key on your keyboard and you'll see the overlay went off. And if you want it to show back up, you can press the Q again. So for now, we'll leave it off. And then we'll go ahead and start adjusting this frame. And as we can see, now that snow starts to disappear. So this is actually pretty cool. Let's go ahead and try it on some other parts of our script. Again, you hold down the control key first to bring up the search tool, and then you will need to expand your box holding down the control again. And let's take a look at that. So you don't have to worry if you keep drawing more. The Dustbust node will just keep creating new preview boxes for you, and the adjustment that you made previously will still be taken care of, as you can see here. Okay, guys, two very handy nodes, the marker removal node and the Dustbust node, found under the draw node category of Nuke. I hope you guys enjoyed this demo, and I hope that you'll get to using these nodes in your workflow, as they will definitely speed things up.